comes around once every 5 years, and next Tuesday night census will count 10 million dwellings, making it the biggest in history.
And while the information helps to piece together where we live and what we do, changes to this year's survey has sparked concerns over privacy. But that isn't the only change. Faith is now in the spotlight, with experts predicting Australia could be losing its religion.
For more on this, we are joined by social analyst and demographer Mark McCrindle. Mark, hello. This year's census, how's it different?
Probably the big change is the number of people expected to fill in the census form online or on device, such as this era. 5 years ago, it was still available as an e-census, but less than one-third of Australians filled it in that way. This year, it's expected that more than two-thirds will go for the online version.
So what are some of the examples of how the questions have changed, you know, for example?
Well, that religion question you mentioned is one that's changed. So you used to have all the different religions and denominations listed there, and then at the very bottom it said no religion. No religion is now going to be the first option, because a lot of people are going to go for that. Nonetheless, as last time, 61% chose Christianity in one form or other. It'll still probably be in the majority, but might fall a little bit.
Right. Now, for the first time in the 100-year census history, the Bureau of Statistics is actually going to keep some personal data, and that's got some people worried about privacy.
People do worry about privacy and those names and details being kept for 4 years, but it's for further ongoing analysis of where people live or how they move or indeed age or people born in a certain year and further sort of analysis of the data. The census or the ABS do have a pretty good track record of data security, and I've even looked up the Census Act, and there's serious penalties for people who in any way reveal data. So I think we can relax that it'll be kept secure, but nonetheless some people have been a little worried about that.
And there's going to be some new jobs included which weren't there before.
Well, that's right, yeah. So, I mean, if we think even in the 5 years since the last census, jobs like app developer or cyber security professional or drone pilot, these are new jobs that have emerged. So I'm sure we'll find a lot more jobs other than just teacher and nurse in the census that gets filled in under your occupation.
Right. What about the homeless? Are they included in the census?
They are. Now, even though we're not going to get the census collectors knocking at the door, because most people get a letter and they'll fill it in online, there are a lot of census collectors that work hard to get every Australian counted. Their voice matters. And so for those sleeping rough, there are a whole team of census collectors going out and making sure everyone in Australia in a normal dwelling or an improvised dwelling will be counted in the census.
So when we fill out these forms, what does it mean? What does it mean when the government gets their hands on it? What are they doing with that information, I guess, helping them make particular decisions?
It is all about those decisions for funding, for GST carve-up. Each state gets a certain amount based on how many people live in that state, where zoning should change, funding to different schools. All of this comes from the census. None of it is for any sort of personal analysis. In fact, that can't be revealed. Not even a government agency can request individual data. It's all in aggregate form so that funding and government policy and even individual businesses can access that data for their own business planning purposes.
Is it compulsory?
It is, yes. Like it is to vote in the election. This one, even if someone is not a voter, they still have to complete the census. Every person, even visitors. And you'd actually get a fine of $180 a day if you don't fill it in when you've been asked to. So it does get pretty serious, and people have to fill it in accurately. It's a pretty serious document.
Is Australia pretty cutting edge when it comes to the census? Is this done all over the world? Where do we stand, I guess, as far as, you know, getting all of this information compared to the rest of the world is concerned?
Yeah, well, the Australian Bureau of Statistics, to their credit, should take credit for having one of the best censuses in the world. A lot of countries have dropped from one every 5 years to one every 10 years. Some have got rid of the census altogether and are just taking a small sample of their population. But the problem with that is that you don't get every voice, you don't get everyone included in that. So I think to make it compulsory, to get every person on board and to do it every 5 years is your global benchmark, you know, best practice. So, you know, good on Australia for doing it. And they're saving $100 million this year as well because of going electronic. So I think it's a good news story.
When will the results be released?
Well, we have to wait 8 months for that data to come out, April next year. But that's in record time, actually. Normally it takes a bit longer. With the full data coming out, well, not until 2019. So a little bit of a wait for all of it, but a lot of people to count.
Good stuff, Mark. And it's next Tuesday.
That's right, Tuesday night.
Thanks.
Thanks for joining us. We're going to be back with much more in a moment.